Okay, so you have completed your sketch, which took a great deal of time, and now your worst nightmare, shading. Shading is a very crucial aspect of drawing. Throughout this video, you will learn how to approach shading in a way that will make it an enjoyable process. There are quite a number of shading techniques that can be used, and there's no rule that you should only stick to one, only if you're challenging yourself to do so. For this drawing, I use a 2B pencil, a 4B pencil, and a 6B pencil. Each pencil can give you a range of value from darkest to lightest, as you can see in the value scale. This darkness or lightness is achieved by how hard you press on the pencil or how you angle the pencil, or it can be achieved by the area of your arm that you use to apply pressure to your pencil. To understand how to shade, we must understand what happens when light hits an object. When the light source hits the object, that area where the light is strongest will be called your highlight. And as it moves away, it's going to get darker and darker. So you're going to have your middle values, and then you have your shadow, your core shadow, and then you're going to have your cast shadow. Since the object is opaque, it is going to cast a shadow on any surface that you place it. Now, just like the value scale that you saw earlier, you can break the object into different tonal values as created by the light source. So what I do is to break my object into these little shapes, and then I start with the middle tone. I start with the middle tone because it's not too dark and it's not too light. And it gives me a feel of the pencil.